Hello, my name is Dr. Gerard Hobley. I have produced three videos covering AS level chemistry energetics. This is video number three. This one is about answering exam questions involving Hess's law. Let's just recap briefly what was covered in the last video. However, I must state, before you watch this video, there is important information in the other two videos which will aid your understanding of the contents of this video. In the last film, we looked at different ways of organising information, using Hess's law, using data to calculate thermodynamic quantities from sets of other thermodynamic values. We used a formula, delta H for a reaction equals the sum of delta H formation standard for the products minus the sum of delta H formation standard for the reactants. Then we constructed energy cycles that can help us to envision the problem set. In this video, we will look at constructing energy cycles to solve problems with delta HC, H combustion standard values. We'll look at using bond dissociation energies for the same thing. I will briefly show you how I would do this kind of sum. Me personally, I find it much the easiest way of doing these kinds of problems. So let's look at this now. Here is a typical problem. So given that delta HC standard for propane is minus 2220 kilojoules per mole. Delta HC for propene is minus 2058 kilojoules per mole. And delta HC for hydrogen gas is minus 286 kilojoules per mole. What is delta HR for the hydrogenation of propene given in the chemical equation below? So it's C3H6 gas plus H2 gas goes to C3H8 gas. So let us organise this information into a way that will help us to solve this problem. Let's start by writing out each equation. Delta H combustion standard values, if we remember, are the values for the enthalpy change in kilojoules per mole when 1 mole of a substance is oxidized completely. Oxidation is a chemical process, so for each value of delta HC standard given, there is a chemical equation which describes it. So let's write these equations out. So let's start off with our equation that we're trying to find out what the value for delta HR is. C3H6 gas plus H2 gas. So this is question mark, goes to C3H8. And the second, we're given that the standard enthalpy of combustion of propane is minus 2220 kilojoules per mole. So let's write this out. I'm going to do it in yellow. So C3H8 gas plus 502 gas goes to 3CO2 gas. Sorry, 4H2O liquid, and the value for this is minus 2220 kilojoules per mole. And in red, the value that we're given for propene is, C3H6 gas plus 4.5 O2 gas goes to 3CO2 gas, 3H2O. The value that we're given for that was minus 2058. And we were also given the value for the delta H of combustion for hydrogen gas. So let's write this equation out. Hydrogen, when it's oxidized completely, would go to just water. So it's going to be H2 gas plus half O2 gas goes to H2O liquid, and the value that we were given was minus 286 kilojoules per mole. So we need to reorganize this data, this information. So the first thing that I should look at is propane in this equation is on this side, and in this equation, the equation that I'm looking to recreate by manipulating these other three equations is on the right hand side. So if I reverse this equation and change the sign from minus 2220 to plus 2220, then I would have the propane on the right hand side. So that's the first thing I'm going to do. I'm going to color that green. And let's move all this up here. So it's going to be 4H2O liquid plus 3CO2 gas goes to, make that arrow a little bit longer, C3H8 gas plus 5O2 gas. Now, if I scroll up a little bit, on this equation, I've got propene and hydrogen together. And here I've got propene and hydrogen. So if I add these two equations together, let's do this. Add, then that's going to give me the equation that I want. So let's just do that. Let's go to C3H6 gas plus 4.5 O2 gas plus H2 gas plus half O2 gas. Goes to 3CO2 CO2 gas plus 3H2O gas plus H2O gas. Now, what we can see now is I've got 4 H2Os. Let's change that. Let's change this to a 4 H2O. And I've got 4.5 plus half. So let's get rid of that. Get rid of that and make that into a 5. Now, what we need to do is basically, because this one here has been reversed, and in here the sine was minus 2,220. This is going to now become plus 2,220. And here we've added this one and this one together. So minus 2,058 plus minus 2,860 is minus 2,344. So let's just put this number in here. Minus 2,344. Now, if I add this equation to this equation, what's going to happen is that on this side I've got 502, and on this side I've got 502, so I can cross these out, cancel them out. And on this side, I've got 4H2O and 3CO2, and on this side, I've got 3CO2 and 4H2O. So if I just then add both of these together, C3H6 plus H2, both of them gases, goes to, and then here C3H8 gas. And what I did was I'm adding 2,220 plus minus 2,344, and the answer to that is minus 2,4. What we can see is that this equation here is identical to this equation here that we're looking for. So I've basically manipulated and combined the other equations in order to make the equation that I want. And this, what I do to the equations themselves, due to the numbers for delta H combustion, if I do that, I come up with an answer with a sum of minus 124 kilojoules per mole. So let's add it here, minus 124 kilojoules per mole, which is the enthalpy of hydrogenation for propene. So let's just have a quick explanation of something else that we need to basically understand. An exothermic chemical reaction is one which gives out a lot of heat energy to its environment. Such reactions, if you feel the reactor and it is not insulated, will feel either warm or hot if the rate of the reaction is sufficient. Endothermic reactions are ones which absorb energy from the environment. They will similarly feel cold as they absorb the heat from your hand. Let's just write out these two words. Exothermic, that gives out heat to the environment. And we'll do one in, we'll do it in blue. And endothermic, absorbs heat from its environment. We can organize delta H combustion data into energy level diagrams. If we think of combustion, we think of burning, i.e., the generation of lots of heat and gas. If we look at the products of combustion reactions of hydrocarbon molecules, we can see that they're all pretty much the same, usually carbon dioxide and water. Delta HC data is for the complete combustion. So for a hydrocarbon, the products will only be carbon dioxide and water. Their formation usually involves a large exothermic process, i.e. delta HR is large and negative. So you can put these products, these reaction products, at the bottom of the cycle because they have lost a lot of chemical potential energy. Their energy is lower. Let's construct an energy level diagram for the hydrogenation of propene. So here are the three reactions drawn out for you. At the top, we've got the reaction in question, the hydrogenation of propene, and this is I've labelled with a X. Next one, we've got the complete combustion of propane, and remember the value is -2220 kilojoules per mole. Then we've got the complete combustion of propene, and finally the complete combustion of hydrogen gas. So in our energy level diagram, we're going to put the products of the combustion reaction at the bottom, and the reaction in question, the hydrogenation of propene, at the top. So let's draw this out. So at the top, we're going to have C3H6. Plus H2 plus 5O2 and that is going to go to 5O2 plus C3H8. And then at the bottom, and here we've got 3CO2 plus 4H2O. And I'm going to put little red lines underneath these. I'm going to put the states of those in. It's 3CO2 and H2O liquid. And let's do the arrows in green. So I need to put two values in there, and alternatively, a bit of a messy arrow, but it doesn't really matter. So I'm going to label these chemical potential energy levels A, B, and C. That's going to be an X. It's going to be a small a here, and this arrow small b, and this arrow small c. A, B, and C are chemical potential energy levels in which the atoms are organized in a particular way. Moving from one state to another, e.g. A to B, involves rearranging those atoms or changing the pattern of chemical bonding between those atoms. This is the origin of an enthalpy change. We can say that the energy change is a change in the energy stored in the chemical bonds between the atoms involved in the chemical change. Remember, Hess's law is that Energy change in a chemical transformation is independent of the route taken. In this case, we are going from A to B, either directly via small a plus small b, or via chemical potential energy level C, arrows small x plus small c. Therefore, from Hess's law, we can say that x plus c equals a plus b. So let's draw all of this information in. Let's add the information from up here, like these energy values here. And what I'm going to do is get the rubber out and rub some of this extra stuff here that we don't really need. So put these values in. Minus 2058, and this is minus 286, and both of those are kilojoules per mole, and here we've got minus 2220. So x plus minus 2220 equals minus 2058 plus minus 286. X plus minus 2220 equals minus 2058 plus minus 286. It's not very neat. Therefore, x equals minus 2220 Sorry, that's a mistake. Let's do it here. Minus 2058. Minus 286 plus 2220, which equals minus 124 kilojoules per mole. It might be an idea to pause the video here and look at this set of problems. Alternatively, you can visit our webpage where you can download this problem sheet, or you can get the answers to the problems. Answering these problems should give you sufficient practice so you are able to approach this kind of sum with confidence. It should also identify any areas where you need a little extra help. Next, we are looking at mean bond enthalpies. Mean bond enthalpy can be defined as the average energy measured over a range of gaseous chemical compounds required to cleave a particular type of chemical bond, leading to gaseous products. Bond dissociation energies can be represented in the following type of energy level diagram, similar to those we have seen already with other chemical processes. For example, to calculate delta HR for the hydration of ethene, we could show it as if we had dissociated all the bonds, relevant molecules, and are left with a set of dissociated atoms. So let's draw out the reaction. That's a gas. That's a gas. So remember, it's always in the gaseous phase, and that will go to CH3, CH2, OH. And this would be, we'll call this delta HRX. So the energy change value for this reaction could be X. Now, if I just count the different atoms in here, how many carbons have I got? Got one, two carbons. So it will be 2C. How many hydrogens? 2, 4, 6. And one oxygen. So what we've done, we've dissociated every single bond in both of these molecules here, in the water and the ethene, to produce this set of dissociated atoms. And we can do the same for the products. So from this energy level diagram, using Hess's law, you can say that X plus B equals A, because going from here to here directly or via X plus B. Therefore, X equals A minus B. If B is greater than A, then X has a negative value. If A is greater than B, X is positive. Let's now consider the theoretical formation of diethyl ether from ethanol and bromoethane. Just a quick note about drawing organic molecules using skeletal drawings. So here is a skeletal drawing. So each one of these points here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, represents a carbon atom in the skeletal drawing. So this is 6 carbons long, so it would be hexene, 1 hexene, because the alkene's at the terminal end. So each one is a carbon atom. Each carbon atom can form 4 chemical bonds. For any chemical bonds not shown, we're assuming that there is a bond to a hydrogen atom. So in the molecule drawn, carbon number 1 here is CH3, number 2 is a CH2, so we assume this one here has two hydrogen atoms attached to it. This one here has three hydrogen atoms attached to it. Now here, to make up the fourth bond, then we need to put a hydrogen here because there's one, two, three bonds already drawn on it. So to make up the fourth bond, so this is this carbon here is a CH. This carbon here has got already two bonds. Carbon number six has got two bonds leaving it. So therefore, the other two bonds must be to H's. So six is a CH2. Any other bonds, any other atoms that are represented are drawn on, but for the carbon chain, then we don't actually specify that the carbon atom is a carbon atom. We just draw it as the carbon skeleton. So what we're considering is the addition of ethanol to bromoethane. So let's just draw out this reaction. So this is bromoethane, ethanol. This is diethyl ether and hydrogen bromide. So what we need to do is to basically look at all the chemical bonds in each of the molecules in this drawing. So in bromoethane, there is two carbons. So there is one times C-C bond. There are 5 times C H bond, and 1 times carbon bromine bond. In ethanol, we have 1 times CC, we have 5 times CH, we have 1 times CO, and 1 times OH. In diethyl ether, we have two CC bonds. We have 10 times CH. We have 2 times CO bonds. And then finally, in hydrogen bromide, we've got 1 times H bromine hydrogen bromine bond. So what we need to do is look in a table and see what the average bond enthalpies are, and then sum these up for each of the compounds. Here is the table of mean bond enthalpies that I am going to use in this calculation. If you want to check the calculation as we go along, it might be an idea to write these values down. From the table, a carbon-carbon bond is 347 kilojoules. and there's one carbon-carbon bond here. So I'm going to put 347 onto this list here. And then here, there's another 347. And here there's two carbon-carbon bonds, so it's 2 × 347. 4ACH bond, the value is 413 kilojoules, so I'm going to 5 × 413. And the same here, 5 × 413. In diethyl ether, there's 10 × 413. 10, 4, 1, 3. And here, a carbon bromine bond is 290 kilojoules per mole of carbon bromine bonds. A carbon oxygen bond is 336, and a carbon hydrogen bond is 464. In this one, I've got two carbon oxygen bonds. That was 336, and that's now all the bonds in the ethanol, the bromoethane, the ethanol, and the diethyl ether, and all I'm left with now is one hydrogen bromine bond, which is 366. So I'm going to add all of these together now. So total, if I sum all of these up, is 2702. If I sum all of these ones up, it is 3212. If I sum all of these up, it is 5496. Move this up here a little bit. So what I now need to do is I've got to add the total energy of all the bonds in the reactants together, and then the energy of the total bond energy of the products. So let's do and we're going to add those. I come to total values of 5914 and 5862. Let's just underline these values. So representing this as an energy level diagram, we start here with the ethanol and the bromoethane. And if we dissociate both of these things into their respective just atoms, we end up with 11 H's, four carbons, one bromide, bromine atom, and one oxygen atom. And the products would also make the same thing. We, from Hess's law, we can say that X equals A minus B. So in our sum, we are going to say that X equals A minus B. So let's go back to our sum. So let's label these A and B. So X equals A minus B. So X equals 5914 minus 5862. Which equals 52 kilojoules per mole. So let's look at this another way. Let's compare the answer that we get from the calculation using bond dissociation energies to the answer that we get calculating it another way. Given that, for ethanol, the standard enthalpy of formation is minus 227.1 kilojoules per mole. That of bromoethane is minus 90.5 kilojoules per mole. That of diethyl ether is minus 279 kilojoules per mole, and for hydrogen bromide it is minus 36.4 kilojoules per mole. We can construct an energy level diagram for the same reaction. So from Hess's law we can say that A plus X equals B. So what we need to do is just basically put in all these values. So A is minus 227.1 plus minus 90.5. That comes to minus 317.6 kilojoules per mole. And B is minus 279 plus 36.4. That comes to minus 315.4 kilojoules per mole. So because A plus X equals B, then X equals B minus A. And the answer that we get from all of that is 2.2 kilojoules per mole. The two answers, kilojoules per mole and 2.2 kilojoules per mole, are very different. And the sums use different sets of data as their source. That from Delta HF standard is likely to be much more accurate, since the bond dissociation energies use average bond enthalpies across a range of compounds containing that bond. Particular bond enthalpies vary quite widely in organic molecules, so the average for a CH bond is unlikely to accurately reflect the actual value for a CH bond in methane, for example. More specifically, in this example, the value of the OH bond in ethanol is likely to be quite different from that used, it being the bond dissociation energy of an OH bond in water. So, we have looked at solving thermochemical problems using values for delta H combustion and bond dissociation enthalpies. In these videos, I have shown you several different ways of organising information given to help you to solve problems. Also, in video 1, I read out the AS level specification regarding energetics. In these three videos, you will see that we have thoroughly covered the subject matter required, with the exception of calorimetry and some practical chemistry aspects. If you find that you struggle with these kinds of problems, then you need to practice them. There's a lot to remember, and falling down on a small detail is a common problem. Remember, practice makes perfect. I hope that these videos have given you the confidence to tackle chemistry energetics problems in your exams. However, I must again stress the value of practice. Please visit our website https://xscience.press.com. There's a link below this film where you can gain access to videos and associated PowerPoint slides, worksheets and answers, tutorials, in-person tutorials for people living in the United Kingdom, other chemical education resources, a range of educational chemistry videos covering topics which students find most challenging. Those things marked with an asterisk, we will post them as we develop them. Thank you very much for your time.